Hello, thank you for joining me once again on Obesity Universal Statistic House. On today's video tutorial, we shall be looking at how to conduct unit truth test, cointegration test, and ARDL-ECM using EViews. Okay, going straight to our EViews page here, we have our data range from 1985 to 2018, giving us 34 observations. We have the variables of interest. We have EXR, exchange rate, INF, inflation rate, and RGDP, real gross domestic product. The RGDP is the dependent variable. Why is the dependent variable? Why exchange rate and inflation rate here are the two independent variables. The RGDP is the dependent variable. Why the exchange rate and inflation rate here are the two independent variables. Now, before performing unit truth test on each of these variables here, okay, we need to regress each of these variables on its constant and trend to check whether they are both statistically significant. And if they are both statistically significant, we include them in the ADF test. Okay, remember the reason why we are performing unit truth test here is to check the stationarity properties of each of these variables to ensure they are stationary, okay, to avoid having a spurious regression result, okay. To avoid having a spurious regression result is one of the major reasons why we are performing stationarity tests on each of these variables. Okay, remember, before performing unit truth test on each of these variables, you simply regress each of the variables on each constant and trend to check if they are both statistically significant to find out if you are to include them in your EDF, in your unit truth test, okay, in your unit truth test. Now, for us to do that, simply click quick estimate equation, then start with the one, start with the first variable here. We have ESR space C space at trend, okay. You type in at trend, as you can see here, go to your keyboard and select at and type trend, okay. Ensure that the method is least square, okay. Simply click OK. Now, as you can see, when we regress exchange rate on each constant and trend, we look at the probability value here and found out that they are both statistically significant. The reason being that the probability values here are less than 0.05. As you can see, they are both statistically significant. The reason being that the probability values here are less than 0.05. It simply means that when performing unit truth tests on exchange rate here, I'm going to include the constant and trend. So I can as well close this. Now, to perform unit truth test on exchange rate here, simply double click it once, click view, select unit truth test. Okay, now I'll be performing this unit truth test using the ADF, that's augmented decoupler. If you don't want to use it, you can as well select any one of your choice here. Okay, the procedure are basically the same. Okay, the procedures are basically the same. So I'm going to use the augmented decoupler test here. So we're relying on ADF for this estimation. Okay, now we'll start with the level form. Ensure that it's on level, so you start with the level form. Now, because the constant and trend, remember when we performed a regression on the, when we regress the exchange rate on its constant and trend, it was found out that the trend and intercept, the trend and the constant, are both statistically significant. So we're going to select the two of them here. So we'll simply click this to select trend and intercept because they are both found to be statistically significant. And simply click OK. Now look at the probability values here. As you can see, it's greater than 0.05, which shows us that the exchange rate here is not statistically significant at levels. Okay, and also looking at the EDF value here in absolute term, you discover that it's less than each of these values here at critical level at 1%, 5%, and 10% here. Okay, since the probability value here is greater than 0.05, it simply means that the exchange rate here is not statistically significant at levels. So we'll check at first difference. Simply click view, select unit truth test, then click first difference, select first difference, then click OK. As you can see here now, the exchange rate is statistically significant at first difference. Looking at the probability value here, is less than 0.05. Okay, the probability value here is less than 0.05, meaning that the exchange rate here is statistically significant at 5%. And also, looking at the ADF test value here, in absolute term, is greater than 5% level, 5% critical level, as you can see here. So it simply means that our exchange rate here is integrated at order one. The exchange rate is integrated at order one, okay. The reason being that the probability value here is less than 0.05 or 5% level of significant, okay. It's significant at first difference. So you can as well save this by simply click freeze, then select click name, then you can call it exchange rate EXR, maybe ADF, okay. ADF, then click okay, then close this. And as well close this also. As you can see, look at the saved result here. You can double click to check. Okay, now the next is to look at a unit test for inflation rate. Remember, you regress this particular variable on its constant and trend to check if they are both statistically significant again. And if they are both, you include them in your ADF test or unit truth test, as the case may be. So simply click quick estimate equation. Let's regress the INF on its constant and trend. Okay. Then simply click OK. Ensure the method is least square. Simply click OK. Now, looking at the constant and trend here, they are both statistically significant. Okay, going by the probability values here, as you can see, they are both less than 0.05, which shows us that they are both statistically significant at 5% form. Okay, they are both statistically significant at 5%, going by the probability values here. So, meaning that when I'm performing a unit group test on INF, I'm going to include the constant and trend because they are both statistically significant. Okay, can as well close this. And to perform unit truth test on INF, simply double click it, then click view, select unit truth test. Okay, you start with the level form. Okay, ensure you adjust this back to the level form. Now, the trend and intercept are both statistically significant, so I'll leave it here. Okay, since they're both statistically significant, remember when we regressed the inflation rate on its constant and trend, it was found to be statistically significant, both the constant and intercept. The constant here is also known as the intercept. Okay, we have the trend, then simply click OK. Alright, at 5% level of significance, you discover that it is not statistically significant. Going by the probability value here, is greater than 0.05. And also, the absolute value here of the ADF test statistic here is less than 5% level here, going by the absolute values, okay? It's less than 5% here. Which shows that INF here is not statistically significant at levels. So we check at first difference. Simply click view again from this page, then select unit truth test. Then this time around you select first difference, then click OK. Now as you can see at first difference, the probability value here is less than 0.05, which shows that inflation rate here is statistically significant at first difference. And also if you look at the ADF test statistic here, in absolute term is greater than 5% level. Okay, which shows that inflation rate here is integrated at order one also. It's integrated at order one, and the reason being that the probability value here is less than 0.05. So we can as well close this. Then lastly, we check for RGDP. Remember, you regress the RGDP on its constant and trend to see if they are both statistically significant. Then click quick estimate equation. We have RGDP space C space at trend. Okay, type in at trend. As you can see, ensure the method is least square. Then click OK. Now, if you look at the constant value here, the probability value of the constant here or the intercept, the score is less than 0.05, which means that the constant, okay, is statistically significant. But if you look at the trend here, the probability value here is greater than 0.05, which means that trend here is not statistically significant, meaning that when performing a unit truth test on RGDP, I'll restrict the trend and only allow the constant to be, because the constant was only one found to be statistically significant. So I'm going to perform unit truth test on RGDP without the trend. However, I'm going to include the constant. So you can close this. Okay, to perform unit truth test, simply double click this RGDP, then click view, unit truth test. Start with the levels form, ensure you adjust it back to the level. Okay, then the trend was not found to be statistically significant, but the intercept was found. So I only select intercept because it was only the intercept that was found to be statistically significant at 5%. Remember, when we regress the RGDP on its constant and trend, it was only the intercept or the constant was found to be statistically significant. Okay, so I'll leave everything as the way it is. Remember, you select levels to start with level form and click OK. Now, if you look at the probability value here, it's less than 0.05, which shows us that the RGDP is statistically significant at 5% level. And also, if you look at the ADF value here in absolute term, you discover that it's greater than 5% level here, as you can see. Okay, which shows that the RGDP is integrated at order zero, meaning that it was found to be statistically significant at levels. Okay, meaning that RGDP is integrated at order zero, because it was found to be statistically significant at level form, going by the probability value here, which is less than 0.05. If you want to save this result also as we did before, simply click freeze and click name. You can call this RGDP EDF. Okay, then click OK. You can as well close and this. Now remember, when we perform the ADF test on exchange rate and inflation rate, they were both found to be integrated at order one, meaning they were found to be stationary at first difference. However, the RGDP was found to be stationary at levels, okay, meaning that it was integrated at order zero. So here it means that we'll have a mixed order of integration of order 1 and of order 0 amongst our variables of interest, which shows that we're going to perform a bound test, that's ARDL bound test, to check if they have a long-run equilibrium relationship among themselves. Okay, to check if they have a long-run equilibrium relationship among themselves. Okay, remember they were found to be integrated at mixed order. Now, to perform ARDL bound test for cointegrating relationship, simply click quick, then click estimate equation. The dependent variable comes first, RGDP, space C, space. We start with the independent variable. Here we have EXR, and the second is INF. Okay, under this method here, we click this drop-down button and select ARDL. Okay, now I'll allow the EViews to do automatic lag selections for me. Okay, for dependent variable, maximum lag will be 4. For independent variables, the maximum lag also will be 4. Now, click these options here. Under model selection criteria, if you don't want to use the AIC, which is the default setting, you can click this drop-down button and select any one of your choice. Okay, select any one of your choice. But however, I'll rely on AIC, which is the default setting here. Okay, I'll allow AIC, which is archaic information criteria, to be. So click back specification here to go back to this page. Now, under fixed regressor trend specification, click the drop-down button here and select constant and trend. Okay, the reason being that we want to check if the constant and trend are both statistically significant. If they are both statistically significant, I'll include them in the ARDL model. However, if they are not, if any one of them or both of them are not statistically significant, I'm going to restrict them. Okay, so let us start with the constant and trend. Then click OK. Now, the first thing you need to look at is to look at your constant and trend from this page here. The constant here was found to be statistically significant, and the reason being that the probability value here is less than 0.05. But the trend is not statistically significant, as you can see here. It's greater than 0.05. So I'm going to restrict trend and allow only constant to remain in the ARDL specification. So I'll simply go back to estimate. Okay, click the drop-down button and select only constant, because it was the only one found to be statistically significant. Okay, remember at 5%. Select constant, then click OK. Alright, from this page here, click view, then go to correction diagnostics, then select error correction form. From this error correction form here, you can see your bound test result as well as your short run result of the ARDL. So simply click it once, then scroll down to look at your F bound test. So this is your cointegration test result, as you can see here. Okay, simply look at the F statistic here. The F statistic value here is 10.23713, and is greater than the lower bound at 5% and upper bound and also at 5%. As you can see, this value here is greater than 5% up lower bound and 5% upper bound, showing us that it's a long-run equilibrium relationship between the dependent and independent variables. Okay, it shows that it's a long-run equilibrium relationship between RGDP, exchange rate, and inflation rate. Okay, basically what this means here is that our model here has passed the cointegration test. It shows that it's a long-run equilibrium relationship between the dependent and independent variable, and the reason being that the F statistic value here is greater than the lower and the upper bound at 5% level of significance. Basically, we are using 5% level of significance. Now, if you scroll up here, you have your short-run ARDL result here, as you can see. Now, the first thing you need to look at is the error correction term, which is the one-period lag error correction term here. We'll see it as coin EQ open bracket minus 1. This is the one-period lagged error correction term. Okay, now ensure that it is negative less than 1 and statistically significant. Ensure that it is negative less than 1 and statistically significant. As you can see here, our error correction term, one-period lagged error correction term here, passed the 3 basic criteria. It is statistically significant going by the probability value here, which is less than 0.05, and it's also less than 1 and negative. Now, this particular value here, if you multiply this by 100, you have 96.91%. It shows that there's high speed of adjustment from the short run to the long run. If there's any disequilibrium in this system, okay, if there's any disequilibrium in this system, it takes an average speed of 96.91% to adjust back from the short run to the long run. Okay, if there's any disequilibrium in this system, showing that there's a high speed of adjustment from the short run to the long run. Now, if you look at the R squared here, discover that the model also has a good fit going by the R square value of 76.61%. If you have to multiply this by 100, it shows the model has a good fit. Now, if you look at the F statistic for overall significance of this model, you discover that the model here also passed the overall significance test, which went by the probability value here, which was found to be statistically significant, as you can see. Alright, every other thing remains the same. You can interpret any of this in your analysis, as you can see the probability values of each of your variables. Now, for us to look at the long run form of this model, simply click View, okay, select coefficient diagnostics, then click long run form and bound test. Okay, you can as well see the bound test result here, which is a replica of what we have earlier on. Click it once, simply scroll down, you see your F bound test result, which is a replica of what we have earlier on. Look at the F statistic value here, which is greater than lower and upper bound at 5% level of significance. So look at your long run result here. As you can see, we have the exchange rate value, coefficient value, standard error, t-statistic and probability value. The exchange rate here is not statistically significant. As you can see here, the probability value here is greater than 0.05. But the INF, which is the inflation rate, is statistically significant going by the probability value here, which was found to be less than 0.05. The exchange rate has a negative relationship with RGDP, and also the inflation rate here also have a negative relationship with RGDP. Why? Because the coefficient values here are having negative signs in front of them. Okay, remember the bound test here, the F statistic bound test here, is a replica of what we have earlier on that we checked earlier on. We show that it's a long-run equilibrium relationship between the dependent and independent variable. The reason being that the F statistic value here is greater than the lower and upper bound at 5% level of significance. So we've been able to show you how to carry out the unit root test, the ARDL bound test, as well as error correction form of your ARDL and the long run form of your ARDL analysis or result. Okay, so basically this is how to perform all of this. If this is your first time of tuning to this channel and watching our videos, kindly click the subscribe button to get more video updates. If it's your first time of coming to our channel to watch our video, kindly click the subscribe button to get more video updates and analysis. And kindly share this video with your friends or any other person that might likely have need for them for their academic purposes. Okay, kindly share it with your friends or any other person that might have need of it for academic purposes. If you have any question to ask, kindly drop your question in the comment section of this particular video. All right, thank you for watching.